Yeah, now that we learned about Lightning, let's actually train a multilayer perceptron in PyTorch using Lightning. And as always, in part one here, we will start with a general dataset inspection. Since we are going to work with the MNIST dataset again, let's make ourselves familiar with it again and go over some code for the data loading that we used in unit 4. Just to make sure that we are on the same page, here are the software libraries I used. And then, as the next step, we are going to load the dataset. So for that, we are going to use exactly the same code we used in unit 4, where we fetch the dataset using the Torch Vision library here. And then we're just making sure the length of the dataset is as expected. And again, this is code that we already used in unit 4. Another piece of code we had was to split the training dataset into a training and validation subset. So let's do that as well. And we are initializing the data loaders here again, using a batch size of 64. Another thing that is always recommended, as we previously talked about, is checking the data distribution. So here we are using the same code from unit 4, using counter to make sure that the label distributions are as expected. So while this might be a little bit boring, we have seen that already in unit 4 for MNIST, this is something I always recommend each time you're working with a new dataset, just to make sure you know what you're working with. Then another thing that I always recommend is a zero rule classifier or a majority rule classifier. So the majority rule classifier is a dummy classifier that will always return the most frequent class label. A majority rule classifier is always a good idea, especially if you are working with an imbalanced dataset, because that will give you the baseline that you want to beat with your machine learning approach. And then as the last step for new datasets, especially for image datasets, I recommend doing a quick visual check. So in this quick visual check, we are using the make grid function from Torch Vision here for visualizing a few images, in fact 64 images here from the MNIST dataset, so that we know approximately how they look like. So our goal here is to implement the training procedure using Lightning. In this particular notebook, we looked at the dataset, and in the two upcoming videos, we will be training the multilayer perceptron in PyTorch using Lightning.